Good morning, dear students. In the previous session, we learned about radiation effects. What is inner Van Allen belt? What is outer Van Allen belt? What happens if the satellite is prone to the sun radiation effects? Okay, so we completed the previous session till this topic. Today, we will go to next topic, that is delay and throughput considerations. In satellite communication, delay is there. There will be no much considerable delay actually. Okay, but if the users are interaction between the interaction between the users is very fast. Okay, then sometimes there might be some delay or echo. Okay. For example, if users are continuously talking to each other for a specific time, there may be a chance of in mobile communication, there may be a chance of listening their own voice, okay, in the phone, listening their own voice in the phone, okay, that is called echo. So there might be a problem of echo, and echo can be solved. Echo problem can be solved by introducing echo suppressors and also echo cancellers. Okay, so like this, the delay and their efficiency can be delay can be reduced and efficiency can be improved. Next, system considerations. There are four important factors that influence any satellite communication system. They are incremental growth, interim operations, replenishment operations, and end-to-end system implementation. Incremental growth. What is incremental growth? What is the fundamental cause or reason to launch a satellite? Yes. In order to know the weather, to weather forecast, forecasting the weather. The next one is to establish the communication between one country to another country. Okay, so and also to raise the profits, improve the economy of the country. Okay, this happens. So it doesn't happen on the day one when the satellite is launched. It happens slowly. Okay, and increases. Okay, after some time, and it will be high at the end of the satellite lifetime. This is called incremental growth. Next one is interim operations. What is interim operation? See here, when the satellite initially, earlier days, when the satellite is launched, okay, only we use it to establish communication only, or only weather forecasting. Okay, if the satellite is launched for weather forecasting, it will do only weather forecasting. Okay, launched for communication, it will do only communication. It is used for communication purpose only. But now, today you see, best example is we are able to achieve location identification using any three satellites that are revolving in medium Earth orbit. That is GPS, global positioning system. Okay, so in order to find the location of to find the location, okay, of any person, okay, so we are utilizing any three satellites in the medium Earth orbit. Okay, this is called interim operations. These are called as interim operations. The next one is replenishment operations. See, we already studied about redundancy. Okay, what is redundancy? Means introducing some excess spare parts inside the satellite. It may be related to the number of solar panels. It may be related to the number of amplifiers in the transponder. It may be related to the number of devices, whatever it may be. Okay, we are at every stage, the satellite is equipped with redundant parts. Okay, So that is the reason, if the satellite is failed at any time due to some misbehavior of the any part or failure of any part, immediately we are able to restore the behavior of the satellite using the redundant part. Okay, so this also affects the satellite communication system design. Yes or no? Next one is end-to-end implementation. Here it is very simple. End-to-end implementation means it should be able to perform transmit and receive operations. One end transmit, one end receive. Okay, so it should be able to transmit the signals, it should be able to receive the signals. Okay, so this is called end-to-end system implementation. So these are called as the factors that influence the design of any satellite communication system. Okay, right, we move to the next topic. So the next one, this is very important. It is Operation NGSO Constellation Design. NGSO means non-geostationary orbit. NGSO means non-geostationary orbit. There are seven satellite constellation designs. What is actually constellation? Constellation means group. Satellite constellation means group of satellites. Satellite constellation means group of satellites. What is group? What is the satellite group? What is the sun? It is very new thing. Okay, see, listen to me here. We know, we already studied in the earlier sessions. Okay, like when we are studying about the onboard TDMA process. Okay, or SS switch, satellite switch TDMA onboard processing. I said that when the satellite is coming towards the Earth station, so it will be transmitting the packets. Okay, it is going away from the Earth station till certain extent, certain distance, it will be transmitting. After that, it will give relay to another satellite. When it is going beyond the vicinity of the Earth station antenna direction, it will give the relay to another satellite. So Earth station will be connected to another satellite to receive the signals. How another satellite will be giving the signals? Whose satellite is this? Is it our country satellite? No, it may not belong to our country satellite. It may belong to some other country satellite. Are you able to understand this? So here, certain countries come together, okay, in order to establish communication among those countries. Well, good communication. They come to one, they say that we together establish a communication system in our countries, okay, among our countries, okay, so that it will be very much helpful to all the people. So in this point of view, one satellite will be interlinked with another satellite. One country satellite will be interlinked with another country satellite. Like that, group of satellites will be interlinked together. This is called satellite constellation. So like that, there are so many constellations in the space. And there are the countries named those constellations with some names. Okay, so here actually seven constellation designs are mentioned, but actually there are now there are so many constellation designs. But whatever it may be, let us see what are those seven constellation designs. First one is Ellipso, second one is Global Star, third one New Echo, fourth one Iridium, fifth one Orbcomm, sixth one Skybridge, seventh one Teledesic. Let us repeat: Ellipso, Global Star, New Echo, Iridium, Orbcomm, Skybridge, Teledesic. Okay, these are the seven constellation designs. When we come to the exam point of view, in the exam point of view for the students, the question is not, they are not asking to explain all the seven constellation designs, at least three or four. at least any three or four constellation designs need to be explained. Okay, so in this regard, you need to read all these, but you need to present only three or four, whatever the question you ask. Okay, but today, whatever it may be, today we'll see at least two. Okay, in this session, I will give two constellation designs explanation. Okay, right. Let us see iridium. Iridium. Why iridium means generally iridium is a frequently asked question in the exam. So that is the reason I have taken iridium to explain. Iridium contains 77 satellites. What is iridium actually? Iridium is the name of the element in the periodic table. Okay, you have learned periodic table of elements. Okay, in that you can see iridium. Iridium is an element. Okay, why iridium is chosen? Because actually there are in this group 77 satellites are present. 77 satellites are present. Since 77 is the atomic number of iridium, this group name was mentioned as iridium only. That is the simple okay explanation. Okay, so in this group, okay, the constellation consists of 66 active satellites, which are spaced 30 degrees apart. Iridium satellites are generally used to provide voice and data communications. Iridium satellites are generally used for voice and data communication. Best example I want to give for this constellation design. When an iridium customer places a call from a handset, okay, he wants to talk to his friend through mobile phone. Okay. It connects to the satellite overhead that we know, and the signal will be relayed among these satellites, okay, to whatever the satellite above the appropriate earth is located. Just know whatever I have mentioned. I want to talk to my friend. One person is talking to his friend. Okay, so he is communicating to his friend through satellite. Okay, through satellite. So here, when the satellite is moving away from the vicinity of the earth station, it should be relayed to another satellite. Okay, because the user is continuously talking, the user might be continuously talking for 15 minutes or 30 minutes or more than that. The satellite will not stay for the user to talk for 30 minutes in the space. It should be revolving. So it will be going away from the vicinity of the direction of the earth station antenna. Immediately it should give relay to another satellite so that the user will be connected to another satellite. Okay, here the communication between the two users is not disturbed. Yes, that is the main purpose of constellation. Okay, that is the main purpose of constellation in iridium or whatever it may be. Okay, now let us see the global star constellation. Satellite constellation. Global Star is a low Earth orbit constellation. Satellite constellation generally for satellite phones, military purposes. Okay, satellite phones are used by military people. And low speed data communication. Generally, Global Star orbits have an inclination of 52 degrees. And Global Star does not cover. Since this is inclination is 52 degrees, though Global Star does not cover polar areas. They will not cover the North Pole and South Pole of the Earth. Okay, due to this low orbital inclination. And Global Star height, that is altitude, is around 1400 kilometers. Okay, so 500 to 1500 kilometers, this range is for low Earth orbits that we know. So Global Star satellites help give assurance that the call is not dropped even if the phone is moving out of sight of one of the satellites. Same iridium or whatever it is. Okay, this the purpose is same. Okay, if the person is making call to another person, okay, so Global Star will give assurance that the for example, the user is in traveling, he's moving from one place to another place, he will be connected to another satellite immediately. He will be connected to another satellite immediately in this case. Okay. So like this, the users will not feel any discomfort or inconvenience, okay, to use all the communication services by the satellites, okay, when satellites are formed as a group, which are called as satellite constellations. So like this, just I have explained Iridium and Globalstar. There are other constellation designs also, okay, which are giving good services for the users. Thank you very much.